Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We have the SGI graph here with magnitude 5.5 and large earthquakes in the previous time frame. And we see a magnitude 7 earthquake at Kamchatka, and it comes after the critical lunar geometry, especially on the 14th, 15th. I explained the critical lunar geometry and that there was the potential for a magnitude 7 earthquake. And I estimated around the 16th. It happened a day later on the 17th. We also had a 6.1 at Taiwan and a 5.7 at Fiji. So some clustering there on the 16th, 17th. Then we had this really critical geometry on the 18th and 19th, and I anticipated a large earthquake. That didn't happen. We see some seismic response, but it wasn't really much. We see a 5.7 and in the Philippines, and a 5.5, 5.7, and basically that's it. And to be honest, I'm scratching my head a little bit, because if we look at the large earthquakes in the last couple of years, it's been 3 years since we had a magnitude 8 earthquake, and it's been 1.5 years since we had a magnitude 7.8. And 7.8 and larger, they occur roughly every 6 months on average. And even that has been 1.5 years. So we do not know exactly what's currently happening on the planet. Stress is obviously building, and we can only anticipate the next larger earthquake, but when that exactly is going to be, nobody knows. So we keep track of the critical planetary geometry that we know is critical, just like what we had on the 18th and 19th. But if it is actually going to happen, that's a question mark. Again, it depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust, and if they are not sufficient, if there's not a large fault section with a critical amount of stress, then there will be not a large earthquake. So that's the activity that we had. Note the 5.5 south of Africa, a double 5.5. I will come to that again in a minute. So let's have a look at what we're going to have in the next time frame. This is actually from the 22nd to the 31st. We see this geometry with Venus, Mercury, Uranus, and Mercury, Venus, Uranus. The semi-right angle geometry, we saw that also on the previous SGI graph, and it's followed by Sun, Mercury, Saturn. That happened yesterday, and there could be some seismic response there. Magnitude 6.5 is what we see often following that kind of geometry. That could be later today, probably tomorrow, around the 25th. We see a high lunar peak, so there could be some seismic response there. I guess around the 25th is possible. Then we have Sun, Mercury, Neptune on the 26th. And then things become a bit more critical, as we can see a convergence on the 27th and 28th. Earth, Moon, Jupiter, Earth, Moon, Mars. And that will be followed by some critical geometry with Mercury, Mars, Uranus, and Venus, Earth, Neptune. Two planetary conjunctions on the 28th. So let's have a look at the solar system, how that geometry looks like. Here we see 27th, 28th, critical geometry. A lot of lunar geometry. We see again double 90 degree angles like we had in the previous time frame. That was actually followed by a magnitude 7 earthquake, and that's the kind of seismic response that we can expect from this kind of planetary geometry, because Earth is here with the Moon facing Mars and Jupiter, and at the same time the Moon is making right angle geometry with Venus and with Neptune. The previous time we had it with Venus and Saturn. It resulted in a magnitude 7 earthquake, and now we have it with Venus and Neptune. And so there could be some seismic response. I expect around the 30th will be most critical, following that geometry. Could be 29th if it arrives early, could be on the 31st if it's right a bit late. But around the 30th, I suspect we could see a seismic response to that planetary geometry. And again, depending on the stress levels in Earth's crust, we could typically see a magnitude 7 earthquake, but the Earth doesn't produce magnitude 7 earthquakes all the time. So we have to wait and see what the seismic response will be. It can be a cluster of stronger earthquakes, 5.5 and larger, but there can be a larger earthquake as well around the 30th. So again, we see this lunar geometry on the 27th, and that's conjunctions with Jupiter and Mars. We have right angle geometry again with Venus and Neptune. Again, that is critical. And then we have Mercury, Mars, and Uranus in a conjunction, and also Venus, Earth, Neptune at the same time. There are actually several hours in between. That is the geometry I think that we should pay attention to, and the days following that geometry. So we had this critical geometry on the 18th, 19th, four planetary conjunctions, but so far no large earthquake, nothing mid-7 or larger. At this point, I waited a couple of hours today on the 24th, whether or not we could see a seismic response to that geometry, but because sometimes it happens 5 days or 2.5 days from the latest lunar geometry, but nothing happened. So I don't think that that is still a possibility, but I cannot be 100% sure. So we focus on the geometry that we have yesterday, the 23rd, again, around the 25th, could be some seismic response there. It could go well into the 6th magnitude range, but especially around the 30th, I think that is a critical time. If we look at atmospheric fluctuations, we had some seismic response south of Africa to atmospheric fluctuations that we had over Africa to the west and also to the east. That was on the 22nd and on the 23rd. I also marked some regions in the Mediterranean, Greece in particular, but so far no really significant seismic activity happened there. It's still a possibility. Thus far, it happened south of Africa, but there's definitely the potential for stronger seismic activity there. Around Greece, it's been over 2 years that Greece had a 6-magnitude earthquake, and it could be right around the corner. So be on extra alert. And that's the potential that we have. Check out the website and also the latest updates in the social media, atmospheric fluctuations. We have dedicated channels for that information. Stay safe. Until next time.